Syria is accusing Israel of attacking targets on the outskirts of Damascus after an aerial strike that sent a fireball over the capital. Our Middle East editor, Elliot Gotkin, joins us from Tel Aviv now with the latest. So, Elliot, what's the reaction in markets been like to this?
Well, yesterday we did see small declines in stocks. They were down 0.1%. We saw declines in Israel's benchmark bonds, borrowing costs ticking up by 0.1%. And we also saw the shekel weakening a little bit, but that could also be because the Bank of Israel has been intervening in the markets to deliberately try to weaken the shekel against the US dollar. So there are reactions to what's been going on there. I should say that Israeli stocks today, this is the second trading day of the week, they are broadly unchanged at the moment. I suppose more broadly speaking, the biggest reaction that we've seen is in oil prices, with Brent crude ticking up above $105 a barrel, and NYMEX futures also having their biggest three-day gains in some 9 months, Manus.
Elliot, President Netanyahu is en route to China. Now, what does he hope to actually accomplish from this trip? Stronger ties economically?
Certainly for Prime Minister Netanyahu, that's the main aim of this trip. And Israel and China already have a pretty good trading relationship. China is Israel's third biggest trading partner. The trade is worth about $8 billion between the two. Israel wants to boost that to $10 billion within the next 3 years. And many big Israeli companies and products made in Israel are already being exported to China. We're talking about products from Intel's facility here, things for drugs from Teva, the generics drugs maker, chemicals from Israel Chemicals, drip irrigation from Netafim and the like. So certainly Netanyahu will be trying to boost that trading relationship. At the same time, he may try to get China to see things from Israel's perspective vis-a-vis Syria and Iran. But ultimately, China, in that respect, will do what is in China's best interest. And given that it imports a lot of oil from Iran, Netanyahu is not going to have a huge amount of luck on that front, one would think.
Elliot, thank you very much.